Hi, my name is Nziki Ngako, and I was born in the Eastern Cape, born and bred in the Eastern Cape. I now live in Johannesburg. So I've been asked to share just 5 minutes short talk about my life's journey, about the beauty of my life, the role, the pains, the fulfillment and the success, just to motivate young people on how to focus on your career or maybe your career guidance, or even how to know your purpose and know where you have to be in life. Purpose comes, you know, after your passion. You identify your purpose through your passion. Passion is things you like. When you wake up in the morning, what motivates you to wake up and do what you do? Besides the skill you go to school and study and be trained in that. But there's a gift within you. When you wake up, what you love to do, what you want to be, what you want to achieve in life. So for me, I make a balance of this because my purpose, it runs, and my passion, it runs over my gifts, my skill, my role at work. I am a coach, business coach and life coach and mentor, and I do leadership training and development, and I also do executive placements. I do a lot of networking. I have to squash up everything in 5 minutes, so you pick the pieces that work for you. So in this talk, what I want to emphasize is that know yourself, know who you are, know your abilities. Your abilities will work better for you in life because you will not be strained by things that you have been trained on and skilled on to do when you are able, naturally born, to do what you want to do. And also know yourself. Your personality as well is important. On the personality, take this one trait that I'll tell you about. Integrity. Integrity means you have to do right all the time, even when nobody can see that you are doing right now. But always make sure your heart is doing the right thing, that you cannot hide with anybody. That's the greatest thing. Your personality will take you into the greater heights. I am a very organized person. I work in structures. So I have a book even now in front of me to respect you and to respect what I'm doing, to jot down what is important. Learning curves, you have to know your subject matter. What you choose in life, what is your passion and your purpose, know it very well. And make sure that you upskill, you research. There is so much online, or even to talk to people who are doing exactly what you like. Knock on their doors, don't be scared. Have confidence, stand up for your rights, because it is your right to have knowledge from someone who has done it before you. I am a great networker. I talk to people. I go to forums where people do exactly what I'm doing or what I'd love to do more to increase on what I'm doing. So I connect a lot with people locally and internationally. I keep track of my calling because I have a passion for people. I have a passion for ministry, so it runs before the workplace most of the time. So I have to balance it so that also at the end of the day, when you do that, you make sure that you are also getting some returns on investment on what you are doing. Because you can't just work with passion only and not do the work. That will give you the resources for you to wake up in the morning and be able to live a life and to take care of your basic needs. I mean, money is important in life. Your passion is important. Your purpose is important. You cannot, even if you have passion and purpose, you cannot help the next person if you don't have a little bit of money to help that person with. So keep the check and keep the balance. For me, that was the pain. Most of the times, I allowed my passion and purpose to run before the business. And even where I needed to help people, all I could offer was just maybe prayer and support, ear, listening ear, and comforting, and not be relevant to help with maybe a bread, you know, a loaf of bread and anything that can help a person who's in need with. So keep the check. Ministering You are a minister wherever you are.